I'm Claire Taylor. I'm from Barrow, New South Wales, in the Northern Tablelands. I'm in my second year at ANU studying science. My mum and dad grew up in Gara, went to school and made their lives here. My mum is a receptionist at a car dealership in Armidale, which she's been at for 2 years. My dad is a rural postman, so he has mail run, which covers quite a lot of ground. I have one older sister who's 9 years older, who I'm really close to. She's also expecting a baby, which is very exciting. It's the first grandchild to come into the family, so lots of preparations are being made for that, and mum and dad are ridiculously excited to be grandparents. It's really such a nice atmosphere at the moment. My favourite thing when I come home is to spend time with my family.
I look forward to mum's cooking, such as steak and mashed potatoes, things I've been craving for the last few weeks.
When she comes home, we don't curtail our activities, but we don't go out a lot, so it's just family time. We just make the most of it, really.
Yeah, she used to come out working with me on the mail side of things, you know.
Sort mail together.
Sorting the mail, delivering the mail.
It's just spending time together that you obviously miss out on when you're not at home.
The decision to leave home was something that I really wanted to do. I really wanted to spread my wings and see what was out there. Gara is such a small community. It is very close-knit and very supportive, but at the same time, I sort of wanted to see what it was like to do things for myself and of the world a little bit, I guess. When I decided to go to university, I didn't realise how much more individual work and motivation it would take. At school, you don't realise how much your teachers are there to push you, to make sure you've done your homework, or to make sure you're going to hand that assignment in tomorrow. Whereas at university, it's all up to you. You have to know when things are due, what's going on. The university and also college has a lot of things in place for support for students. The lecturers are always happy to go over things or for you to email them if you don't understand anything. Also, college has an academic network in place, so that's really helpful to have past students of that subject who can reassure you that it will all be okay and you'll get there in the end. Canberra and Gara are definitely worlds apart, so it was hard, but at the same time it was really what I wanted to do.
Over the last number of years, we've had an increased number of students who've particularly gone into tertiary education, and I think that's because there's also a much wider range of courses than there has ever been offered. We've seen students go into a much more diverse range of universities than we've ever had. They've moved away from New England area, so for Clare we've gone down to ANU. We've also seen the nature of Gara change over the last 5 years, particularly with the result of the tomato farm and the opportunities that's offered in terms of being both a grower and also the trades that are associated with it. Claire's big shift was going to the National Youth Science Camp. I think that's when you decided.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you wanted to go ANU.
Yeah, that was when I found out about ANU and also its reputation for science. My science teacher basically told me about this opportunity and said, well, why don't you give it a go? And then I also approached Rotary because they're involved with the National Youth Science Forum, and they said they were 110% willing to support me, as no one from Gara had ever attempted to go before.
Claire was always one of the most hardworking students that I've ever taught, but she was also extremely hard on herself. So part of my role was to try and bring her back down to earth and realise that she could do it.
Chemistry classes were the most fun classes at school. That sort of environment encourages learning because it's so much easier when you're enjoying what you're doing to sort of further that. And of course, Yvette has just been an amazing pillar of support, and with support you can do pretty much anything.
She's always been the sort of kid that, you know, if she wanted to go somewhere, she'd say, well, Mum, you know, I want this to happen. And we'd say, well, yeah, you do it, you work it out, you organise it. She'd organise it and it was fine. We trusted in her judgement that she had a fair idea of what she wanted to do and where she was going.
Any student who is considering going to tertiary education, especially those from rural areas, you won't know until you try. If you're determined and your heart is set, that is what you want to do, or even if you just sort of want to find out more about it, definitely investigate the situation. there are so many experiences that I've had now, so many friends I've made at ANU, which I wouldn't have done if I hadn't have gone to college and university. So it's definitely a worthwhile experience.